Interestingly, starting off with the laboratory of Lord Vyemm this evening, instead of Deathtoll. Interesting. Thus, really mad, so. Oh my god. What's going on here? It's like me casting Jester's Cap on Avon is like some sort of really strange curse. Also, those ads are like in a really weird place. I feel like I'm way too close here and I'm about to get absolutely shafted. It's like the Vyemm pools are not as terrible as last time we were in here.
the range on that?
Whirling talons. Is that one of those super close ones where, like, it will only hit you if you're within meters or something? Is that the sound of dirge rezzes I can hear? Yeah, see? Actually, I mean, I might have been at 5 meters when that went off, and we definitely didn't have any group avoider. Nope, that's the wrong button. Oblivion's Edge. Oh, 6 second delay. Probably need to find a weapon that I can use in the offhand short term while working on the whole Claymore thing. Probably need to get rid of the prismatic one. Probably a level 70 weapon with a reasonable damage rating is going to now outpass the level 50 weapon with the proc. Not such a case at level 60, but I think at level 70 it will be. Jester's Cap Avon again, would he die on Paul? Just therefore proving the curse. Oh, the stuns. This guy's like, yeah, I shall memoir for days.
We are the Legion!
Ooh, Belt of the Doom. Oh, I don't know why I say ooh. Literally any waste item is going to be pretty sure worse than the Heritage Quest one. It's not bad. Flurry multi-attack. For a pure DPS scout, maybe? Briggy Swashing? We normally fight this one. Quack. Was there some trash first? Oh, for some reason I thought there was trash first before they're named. Guess not. Engage walk mode. Evening Megaton. What is up? Welcome to the Labs of Lord Vyemm. luxuriating in labs. Yeah, something like that. Fade into oblivion. I thought there was going to be some stompy stompy coming. No stomp? Stomp go off and I just missed. Okay. Rough. Get blobbed! Good old AoE intent thing again. 15 seconds later. Where's it gone? It's the last night, raid night before Christmas, and all across the land, raiders were partying. Oh, for God's sake. Go into DPS the ads and then just get AoE'd. I literally pressed the AoE avoid button. That is so annoying, and it just hadn't gone off because of the time in between casting two abilities, of which my brain is... Gonna stay out here for now. Awesome debuffs. Way too much death in that fight. It started off all right, and then just suddenly, like, what, three deaths in a row or something stupid. Very bizarre. Ustelastus. That's a name.
Yeah.
something is deathless, does that mean it has never died? Or does it mean it cannot die? Whee! Oh, I need to fly once. Sash of Perdition. Actually, not bad. Casting speed and ability modules. The stats on that one. If you haven't done the Heritage Quest, it's not bad. Oh, Senego Splatty, Splatty. Oh. Alright, I saw him casting something called Doomed, and I was like, oh god, he's out of area that's gonna obliterate everybody.
Yeah.
again. I'm guessing that must be another AoE that is about 2 meters distance or something weird, because I've seen a lot of scouts get hit by and get thrown back. In the... I'm sat here at 4 meters going, what? Unless it's one of those that only hits like the closest 4 people or something weird. That guy does remind me of Darathar a little bit, where he absolutely spams the freaking in-game chat. Rakhtlesho, Runeblade of the Doomflight. That's that big old, yeah, two-handed fiery blade, yeah. AE auto and multi-attack. I don't like this next fight. as a scout, I'm just gonna have to sit here and do nothing. It's rubbish. This is the one where we died lots. Because freaking AoEs kept going off. This one you... So you can't avoid, like, you, I think the AoE gets cast like once a minute or something, and there's no way to avoid all of them. I think this is the wrong pool spot. And everybody was dying! Is this game dying? No, this game isn't dying. A raid's dying, the game isn't dying. I mean... Isn't every game dying in reality? Like, just birthed into a world and then it is permanently dying from that point forward? I don't know. Oh my god, really? AoE in 5 and then it literally punts us in the face. I didn't even get a chance to cast the flipping blade dance because it just went bang. On the plus side, it didn't kill me, so I shouldn't complain too much. But... If I turn on ranged auto attack, does that count as a... Maybe not. I know you can't really... You're not really meant to be able to melee this one without getting some feedback. Yeah, blade dance, baby. This tortoise shell's not going to be up. Blade dance isn't going to be up for the next one. I think it's just a trauma AoE, isn't it? I don't think any resists are going to help. Oh. Oh. I did actually manage to dodge that one somehow. Oh, I didn't actually mean to melee that mob, sorry. Whoops. I just wanted to get in a debuff. Being said, about 15 metres where I was stood here, I didn't actually get hit at all last time, and I don't think there was an AE avoid up either, so. Maybe found a good spot? Such a long fight. Oh, that did actually hit me that time. Didn't kill me though. Troop 3 is taking an absolute battering. That was another one of those incoming in 5 seconds, bang, the AoE hits before the end of the sentence. On the plus side, I shouldn't be broken before this fight ends. Blocking AoEs is for the week. Yeah. Oof. I have a sneaking suspicion that on the last server, by this point, our characters had so much more Ryu speed that in the mage group where you had a Troop and a Fury, you could actually avoid all of the AoEs because the Ryu's was enough for a constant cycle of tortoise shell and just late dance, whereas that's not possible on this server. take AoE to the face. No! I did that in, when we were in here the last time, and I died so many times I was broken by the end of this fight. That time I didn't die a single time, so I'll take it. Frostwrath. One-handed. Great haste. That's another 6 second delay though. Christmas bells, Christmas bells. Makes you sad about the Kinos Guard. I did see something about in... Was it yourself who posted it or someone else posted it in Discord how they got the Kinos Guard and it blocked like two hits in a... in an entire raid fight or something ridiculous like that. With terrible stats. How was it? I can't remember who it was. I remember seeing something where it was just like, wow, it's blocked a 2k hit and a 5k hit. Wow. I was about to say, what actual stats does the King's Guard have? Because knowing it would probably end up with flipping like DPS and mitigation or something really weird. Oh, they do have DPS on there, okay. I was partially joking, didn't I? Okay. Oh, look at that! Ability mod casting speed on chain shoulders. God damn my... Damn hunters. Being slightly better. Right, cross your fingers this actually works properly this time. You hear the flap of giant wings coming from above. Dun, dun, dun. I think I saw a wing. I think that went well. Come in here.
I don't waste time on insects. Kill them.
Oh no, no, I'm stuck in the wall. Who rezzed me? God, I can't. I'm not here.
Shh, be quiet.
Alright, he murdered me. Who did that? Oh my god. I'm not actually sure what killed me the first time, to be honest. Because supposedly we had tortoise shell up. Yeah, exactly. It's like, oh, don't eat me. Leave me alone. It's like he's gonna like run past me and eat the raid and reset. Not that it would have helped, because I was literally stuck in my... Really sure which AoE we should be avoiding on pull, because we're back up the stairs, so theoretically we should dodge the first one anyway and then come in after that first one and then blade dance or tortoise shell, so that second one doesn't hit us. Oh, this is gonna go well anyway. Are we all the way back here? I mean, this is excessive, isn't it? This is too far away, surely. To be fair, it does look like we are in combat. You are being attacked! Lies. Guessing I'm gonna have to try and reset him properly anyway. Send in the brawler. The FD. Going. I mean, that's progress. I'm a little bit. Oh, here we go. This is going to be the painful bit, is it? Oh no. Oh, Blade Dance was still running. It's the next LOE. I can dodge myself. Oh no, this is it. Okay. I don't know what we're going to do for the next one, though. Bone strike coming up within about half a second of that AoE hitting. To be fair, I didn't actually kill too many people, so I probably would have been okay anyway, but still. I'd prefer it to be at full health rather than nearly dead. Oh, this is the big one. Actually, you've got Core Shell up, so we should be okay here. I'm screaming. Don't know whether. Oh! No. Energy vortex now. What's gonna happen here? Oh, nothing. Wait, what? is vortex the frontal? Like, I was honestly expecting like most of the raid to just go splat there and then, but we didn't. Oh, it's a proximity thing, is that okay? Rather than a direction. Yes, he's got to be broken by now, I imagine. I'm pretty sure he's died on every AoE. Which, to be honest, felt like my life last week. Quack! Quack, quack! Are the Albus? Hopefully he should be dead before he casts another AoE anyway, so. Ooh, that was close. He was casting it. Nice. Ooh. the Nemesis Vest. Oh, it's another flurry multi-attack, which is really nice for the swashies and the bricks, I guess, but... Someone tried to reset it without leaving the raid. Okay, I think we can just run down there, right? Boom rage. What was that on there? AoE auto DPS. Oh god. Is that the Zerka red one? Oh, that's grey. Whee! Get on, get a rewind. Oh, that Nemesis breastplate. 150, 160. Kazu and Nim going mad. LZ Prime. I guess we only have a couple more opportunities of doing this, right? And then some point early January, maybe, it'll get changed and we'll have to fight them both at the same time, like it was, I guess, originally intended. Assuming the change to the encounter to make it work like that doesn't completely bust it. And then we have to find yet some other random cheese to kill it. In a way, the concept of the TLEs do remind me of, like, you know, your classic speedruns that you would see on Games Done Quick or something like that, right? Where it's just like, right, how many different ways can we find to cheese the encounters so that we're not doing them in the way they were originally intended? Yeah. I mean, I assume, you know, main tank will take Vyemm, and some an off tank group will grab Prime and kill Prime first and then on to Vyemm afterwards. I guess it depends. I mean, if that was if Prime here continues to basically hit as like what he's doing now, then actually I guess you kill Vyemm first, right? And just leave Alzed up. But yeah, very much going to depend on how much of them gets changed, how hard they hit. No, I mean, he doesn't seem to really hit that hard, does he? I mean, he really is just the tank in Spank, so theoretically, if you left him the way he was, he could be off-tanked. And then really, you're only just... I mean, it's going to be take slightly longer to kill Vyemm, that's all, right? Just because you're going to have, I guess, one group focused on... That is a valid point. If you only had one group on him instead of four groups, would he be hitting a lot harder? And then if you've got less debuffs on Vyemm, is he going to hit then slightly harder, making that a bit more tricky? It's a lot of guesswork at this point, and it was just wait and see. I suppose the point, or the other thing is if he ends up being such a pushover, what's the point in having him there? Why is he there? It feels like, at that point, it feels like a thing for the sake of being a thing, but literally pointless. It just makes the fight longer. Yeah, Yes, I see you casting fusion in my face for no reason. Can I drag a guard over so you can cast fusion at a guard and then go splat? Yeah, that's true. More chance of an AoE wiping the raid. Unfortunately, it also means it's more boring. The hardest boss of a long fight is people's tiredness. Their own concentration levels, because they fall asleep halfway through a very long fight. How many tracksuits do I own? Zero. Tracksuits are so 90s. That was a super random question. Had to remind people to stay awake. Oi! Remember to stay awake. Don't fall asleep. I know it's a long fight. Go, go, Gadget Brawler! Run! Snakes, snakes everywhere. Everywhere a snake. Did they reset? Please don't kill me, please don't kill me, please don't kill me. Nobody moved. What? You were talking with Kazu yesterday, he didn't know what an outlet was. What do you guys call the thing you plug a lamp into? Socket, I suppose, I think is probably the most used term. Plug socket? I don't know, maybe that's just a thing that differs from... What are these snakes up to? Worms. I keep calling them snakes. Da 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 da. I'm just gonna stay here. Must be a French thing. Maybe they call it something entirely different. Yeah, I think UK we would just say plug socket. Socket. To be fair, if I heard the word outlet, I think my brain would be a 50-50 between a socket, given the fact that I hear a bunch of Americans talk anyway, and a shop. So I do a lot of like e-commerce stuff at work, so online shopping, and a lot of online shops call outlets like their discount part of their web shops. So yeah. Are these reset now? Yes, they have. Excellent. Good. Right. I have survived. Seems like a very elaborate ruse to set up a deep. No. No telly. We get enough of that with Raven and Guild. You don't need any more. See dead people. I'm okay to just run my ass up here. I don't really trust running down this corridor on my own, though. I'm gonna wait for the rest of the raid here. Normally, you're pretty safe to hug the right wall. But I think last time there was actually a set of worms on the right. So. Why are there Rotongas everywhere? It's just me and two rats. Can we get past these without aggroing them?
Hey!
I know. I this is my argument. Like, they're only groups of threes that we've found, I think, so far. We really should just trip and kill them. Because if we wipe at some point, right, and we have to come back here, we're gonna have to do this all over again. And it just gets to be a mess. It's like, just kill them, and then we can freely run through the zone, at least for a little while. They may respawn at some point. That seems to be a thing. Oh, is that a bigger group? That might be. Oh, I think that's a group of six. That's a lethal group right there. Is it 30 minutes? I know they do if you like leave the zone and let it soft reset. Actually, no, it's five. I mean, that's still pretty nasty. Think we cleared this. I think we cleared all the eyes. Run, 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 run. Oh my God, everybody dead. I know, right? Thankfully, I have not died yet. I have dodged this stupidity so far. The Drake. The Drake that splits in half. We killed that last time we were in here. That's as far as we got. Okay, we've got the trash on the right, and then probably an invis eye here somewhere that I can't see. Aye, aye, come. We got two eyes at once. Oh boy, what could go wrong? Oh, mate. Oh my god. I was literally about to cast AE Avoid, and a freaking the other one in front of me that I'm not attacking cast his AoE first. Ugh. I think it's the frost one that isn't too bad. I think it's the Eye of Fire that is the real killer. Anyway, the eyes are the scariest thing in the zone. Oh, I don't know. I think I'm scared more of those big group of five or six worms, to be honest. But yes, the eyes are a good close second. Right, anyway. Trash.
Die screaming.
The ancient vet. Oh, what is that delay? 1.3 seconds. What is that? Like, if that had been 4 seconds, I would have taken that weapon just temporarily until I got my claymore. But not. I mean, I could buy a thingy off the marketplace, I suppose, to change it to 4 seconds. But... I think I'll pass. currently a debate going on in voice as to whether you can skip the named and go straight to the last two mobs like you used to be able to do. I think some people weren't aware of the what we discussed in the last stream about it having been changed for this server particularly. Pitsy Pitsu! Pitsy Pitsu! Come on, short arms. Double cast, yeah, baby. There it is. The short arm of the law is what he is. Got one person in the raid who doesn't have the item, so they like immediately died on pull. The only downside is it's absolutely spamming the in-game chat window. No one called the flurry, so by the time it started casting, it was way too late to get out. It's getting messy. I killed this book. Can't use the wall because we're engaged with a freaking book. Oh, okay, mate. Maybe we can now. Maybe? No. Oh. Bunch of pansies. What can you do to die less? I don't know, Yeska. What can you do to die less? Stay at ranged. I should probably follow my own advice on that one and stay at ranged. That almost seems like the books respawned instantly that time, as soon as we pulled Fitzy Pitzel. Stupid short arms. Just practicing our extend aroundium skills for a little bit here. Please hold. Wait, was that book damaged? Oh yeah. Maybe that one's broke. I don't think they break like that anymore, do they? They just reset eventually and join in the fight anyway. Gonna wait until old short arm flurry hits. There he is. Go, go, go! Thanks. Evening, Grug. How you doing? Oh my god, someone really mistimed that AoE call. There it is. I basically wasted my AE avoid then. What the fudge was that? That was not short arm flurry, that was something entirely different. Impressive, considering where I was as well. I think this is going well, you know. Destroying the tanks. No, I don't. I'm not sure I want to accept that, Rez, honestly. I mean, maybe. Am I in? Maybe I'm not aggro. I'm going to go jump on this wall because I don't. I haven't actually had mince pie in ages, you know. It's an absolute kerfuffle. I blame the tanks. Gotta be the Guardian's fault, right? short arm flurry. Avoid that. Was the longest 5 seconds in the world, and once again I think I wasted my AE avoid. There it is. That 5 seconds was about 20 seconds. Unfortunately, I don't have my AE avoid now, so I'm definitely going to stand out for this one. There it is. Yeah, my act seems to have gone a bit weird. I think it's since I moved over to running the game in proper full screen mode. I tried like running it as various things, like running it as admin, for example, but he's doing his dingy dingy. Oh. What a buggy mess this encounter is. What's he doing? He was like, you know what, I'm gonna run over the other side, but first I'm gonna fucking destroy your entire raid, then I'm gonna run over the other side. Stupid halfling gnome, small creature, short-armed, pain in the ass. Even might have saved our asses there by feign deathing and not dying. Maybe. Yes, hopefully success part one, and he doesn't do some weird buggy mess in the second part. I mean, he's mostly just the same in part two as he is in part one, isn't he? Does the same AoEs, still spawns the frickin' books. Only this time you actually have to kill him to 0% and not just 60% or whatever it is. Although, books might still be bugged. Seems to do less damage. I'll take your word on that one. The AoE still hits like a mother trucker if you don't avoid it. Fitz Pitzel. I think we'll probably get at least one book because there's only two here, not three. So. Guardian getting absolutely trashed. This is the longest 5 seconds in the world again. God damn it, people. These bugged books are futzing with my tab targeting. isn't assault frontal? Managed to dodge and avoid the frickin' main AoE and then just frickin' die to some crappy assault. These AoE calls. That's discombobulation. God damn it, they called the AoEs wrong again. I feel like someone, whoever's calling this, has got the eye on the wrong AoE and is getting the timer for the. Discombobulation rather than the short arm flow. Unfortunately, I think the actual timer on the AoE is something like 45 seconds, which is shorter than my personal AoE avoid, you know, burn strike. do need to repair though. I did actually swap out one of my charm slots for a hex doll in the end. Mostly just because one of the charm items I was wearing was a treasured quest item, I think. So the stats on it weren't particularly fantastic to begin with, so the hex doll turned out to be slightly better. Die, you wretched gnome! Yeah, people were just saying that. Oh no, does that mean I need to go down to Soul Eye now? Yeah. I was pretty sure that should have been blocked by a tortoise shell. dodged. Oh god, here we go again. Blobby, blobby, blobby! Those words may scare people. I think we're actually gonna skip this name for now. Go around to the next one and then come back to this, maybe. Corpsicles. Is that like a popsicle made out of corpses? Oh god, this is the fun bit of... Oh no, we go down the left first, don't we? It's when you come back up here, you have to go back over this bridge and hope to god you don't get knocked off. Snake!
Hey.
What's the time? How long have we got left? I only got about half an hour left, so I don't know how much more of the zone we're going to be able to get to in half an hour. Random piece of relic gear from trash. Price of those repair kits come down on the broker yet? Will they still like 6-7 plat each? To be fair, I don't know what you actually need to make the item, so I don't know whether the excessive pricing was based on some rare material or... Is the marketplace? Question? Probably. I will have a check in a second. You can buy full repairs. Repair, yes. For 99 of your hard-earned Daybreak dollars. That's true, yeah, with the discount as well. 10% and the discount. Yeah, the best. Was that intentional? It's like the best thing about EOF, right? You should probably rephrase that as a reusable Menderbot with infinite charges on the marketplace for $15. Because I feel like otherwise you'll get a single use charge for $15, which seems a little bit excessive to me. Let's make that happen, yeah. For Alluvium! Then we have to fight this in the water. Going with my own water breathing as well, just in case something goes horribly wrong. How about rechargeable Menderbot? You get 5 charges. If you use them all, you have to pay. You have to recharge it by feeding it a proto.
No.
Plus side, we do have a Fury in the group, which means fish vision, which means we can actually see if we do go underwater. We may be about to die horribly. Someone didn't cast tortoise shell. Some of your equipment is broken. I think this has gone well. That is a nasty AoE. There was enough people broken. Hopefully that grabbed you, it's good. Good to go. It's got to wait for everybody else now. Just play gnome, guys. Free repair. No. I'm not sure even that could make me play gnome, to be honest.
The living are not welcome here. Peritherm shall raise you.
Stupid skeletal drag. Do I dare click the button? Yeah, I know, right? Loading UI resources, please hold. Now we play a game of conjurers do summoning things as whatever. Dive! I hate fighting in water. It's horrid. $40 million health. Are you having a giraffe? Again. Oh. Buggery. That was fun. Vaporous disease. Ooh, that's a big one. Main tank group gold splat. I don't think we're going to be killing this one somehow. I don't remember it hitting this hard on the last server. Howdy, Holgo. How you doing? I think I will. Next server, I'm going to make a mage that can feign death. Oh wait, that's a necro. Then I could sit at the back, and when it looks like it's all going a bit peak tongue, I can just feign death, get out of there, so I don't die. Doesn't always work, but... I don't care about doing DPS. As long as I can feign death, I'm good. I'm happy. I think someone's theory of this being a range-based AoE was not true. I think we were at like 25 meters on pool or something and got one shot, so unless it's an anti-distance thing, and if you're at zero you're okay. Six minutes on Blade Dance. Group one, splat as a pancake. Are we just giving up on this? Was it worth it, really, to mess about going out, repairing, coming back to get one pull in and die? I'll take the clip, we got two pulls and died, didn't we? Then. It's a pretty rough mob, though. I don't, as I say, I don't remember it hitting quite so hard on the last server. But as we know, These things do change over time as various buff packages keep getting tweaked up and down, left and right. So. I'm not going to do it now, but what gems do I actually need for the relic? Scout head. Flawless amber. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we like killed it on kind of like first pull every time on the last server. I don't remember it being a pain at all. I wonder if I can grab the consumable. Things I threw a bunch in there myself. Pristine, exquisite, refined, flawless. Amber, oh. Okay. We need to repair again, don't we? Yes. I was going to say our group also doesn't have really many nox resists. Like most of the other groups have got shamans in with nox wards and dirges in their groups running. Oh, I suppose we would have had the dirge nox run from the raid. I didn't actually stop to check to see how much nox resist I had. Clearly, the answer is we need more health. How much health do I have? I think I had about 10,600 in the raid, which seems terrible at level 70. I can't remember what I had on the illusionist at this point. Anywho, ladies and gentle peeps, that is